Okay. We have reached this example. Okay, we have solved the first part of this example. The electric field is given by this equation at y equals 0, which is 30, amplitude cosine 10 to 9 pi t plus pi over 4 in the z direction. The electric field is in the z direction, and it is propagating in the positive y direction. And y is equal to 0. Here we should have minus beta y, and y is equal to 0, so you can add minus beta y. But if y is not 0, you cannot add, you have to add minus beta y, and you have to take into account the value of beta y at y equal 1. So it is a simple case here. We have solved the first part of this, and we will review briefly the first part. Now we add the exponential decay due to the loss of the finite conductivity of the medium, which is 10 to minus 2 Siemens per meter. So this would be exponential minus alpha y. This will account, or this accounts for the loss due to the lossy medium. And we add here minus beta y, since the wave is propagating in the positive y direction, and y is equal to 0. So we add minus beta y. Okay. So we need now to find alpha and beta. Everything is known here. 30 is constant, 10 to 9 pi is constant, t is parameter or variable, and pi over 4 is constant, and y is the variable, the propagation direction. So the only unknowns in this equation are alpha and beta, and alpha or beta are given by this equation, which is given in the textbook. So everything is known within this equation. Omega is the frequency, radian frequency, which is 10 to 9 pi, everything written or multiplied by t, or the factor of t is omega. So omega is 10 to 9 pi. Mu is given by this equation, mu r. You multiply by mu naught, you will get mu. And epsilon r is given here. You multiply by epsilon naught. Sigma is given here, 10 to minus 2. So everything is known here. We can find then alpha is associated with the minus sign, and beta is related to the positive sign. Okay, so we find here alpha and beta. Alpha is turns out to be 0.94 nepars per meter, and beta is equal to 20.965 radian per meter. Okay, we substitute the value of alpha and beta here, and substitute y equal 1 meter and t 2 nanosecond, and we will get this value. E at y equal 1 meter and t equal 2 nanosecond is equal 2.7887 volt per meter in the z direction. Now the second part, we did not solve it. The second part is, anyone has a question or any comment or any suggestion?
دكتور انا عندي سؤال.
تفضل.
لو كان قال لي مثلا انه الويف بروباجيتن بالنيجاتيف واي دايركشن.
اوكي. سو وات شال وي دو؟ يس تفضل.
بصير انه بضيف بلس بيتا واي.
بلس بيتا واي اكزاكتلي يس يو ار رايت. بس بروفايدد ذات واي از ايكوال تو زيرو. اف واي از نوت زيرو، ذس مينز ذات بيتا واي ويل افكت ذا كونستانت هير. يو سي؟ This, if beta is equal, for example, 1, this means that here there is beta, plus or minus, depending on if it is plus or minus y direction. You understand me? If y is equal to 0, when you put beta y equals 0, beta y will cancel, and it will not affect this value. If the wave is given or the field is given at y different from 0, this means that beta y will affect this value pi over 4. So you have to take that into account. Do you understand? Okay, thank you. Any other question or any other comment, suggestion, anything? No, we continue. Okay, now the second part is distance. Find the distance to have phase shift of 10 degrees. What's the phase shift? The phase shift is beta, the changing thing with distance. T is time, okay, and this is constant. So the only thing changing with distance is y, is beta y. So this will give the phase shift here. So beta y is the phase shift here. So beta y is equal phase shift of 10 degrees. And you convert this into radian. So when we multiply by pi, and pi is equivalent to 180 degrees. You will get, now beta is known, and this is known, you will find why it is 8.3 millimeter, which is less than 1 centimeter to get phase shift of 10 degrees. Is that clear? This beta y, as you know here, I will repeat, in this equation, okay, this does not give phase because this is real, no phase here, and here no phase, and this depends on time, and this is constant. So the only factor that or term that gives phase shift is beta y. Okay, so beta y is the phase shift here. So I concentrate only in beta y. So beta y should equal to 10 degrees. I convert 10 degrees into radian, and beta is given, I find y. That's the whole thing about this part of the question. Now part C, if part B is clear, I will move on to part C. Is B is clear for everyone? Yes or no?
ممكن تعيدها على السريع.
Okay.
ما استوعبت الفكرة.
Okay, no problem. We repeat two times, three times, no problem. Now, you see this is the expression for the electric field. Okay? You can see the expression for the electric field. Now, if you investigate this expression, okay? Now, 30 here is a constant value. It does not give phase. There is no phase. The phase is zero here, yes? It does not change. The phase is constant here. And the phase here is zero also. This depends on time. Yes. Any comment, any question? So 30, the phase of 30 is this zero. The phase of this is zero. It does not change with y. We want distance here. You see distance. So this has no distance. This has distance, but it does not change with the phase, does not change with distance. And this is time, it's not distance. This is constant. So the only term that gives phase shift with distance is beta y. The only term that changes the phase shift with distance is beta y. And as you know, inside cosine is angle. So this is angle, this is phase shift, beta y is phase shift because beta is radian per meter, multiply by meter, you will get radian. Radian is phase shift. So this term will give you the phase shift. This is the phase shift, by the way. So beta y is the phase shift, which is equal to 10 degrees as given here. So beta y is equal to 10 degrees. Now I convert degrees into radians so that because beta y is radian and beta is known, you can find y is equal to the 10 degrees converted into radian divided by beta. That's all. Is that clear now?
دكتور شكرا.
Okay. Now we move to the next part of the question. Okay. Which is part C. Find the distance to have amplitude reduced by 40%. Okay. When he says that amplitude is reduced by 40%, this means that the amplitude is 60% of its value. Yes, when something is reduced by 40%, this means that 60% remains. Yes, if you have something reduced by 40%, this means that 60% remains. So this means that the amplitude is 60% of its maximum value or of its initial value. So here you can see. Now, what here he wants distance. This is time, this is constant, this is distance. Here, the cosine is the amplitude of the cosine is one. Yes, the cosine itself, it has constant amplitude of one. You agree? The cosine, the amplitude of the cosine is constant, it's equal to one. Yes, you know from that from signals and systems. Do you agree? Any objection? Any comment? The amplitude of cosine or sine or exponential is always equal to 1. Okay? Amplitude of cosine is equal to 1. So, what is the term that changes amplitude within this expression? This is direction. Z is direction, okay? Z hat is direction. The amplitude of this is equal to 1. 30 is constant. So the only thing that changes amplitude is exponential minus alpha y. So this is, so if you assume that the initial value is 1, this means that exponential minus alpha y is equal 0.6, okay? Because 60%, 40% has gone. So we are left by 60%. So exponential minus alpha y is equal 0.6. As you can see, it is 0.6. Now alpha is given, and you have only one unknown. You can take the length of both sides and find y. Y is equal 0.5426 meter. That's all. Any comment, any question? Do you want me to repeat this part again? Or is it clear now? It is clear, I will continue the last part of this question. If it is not clear, I will repeat or explain it in another way.
دكتور هون الواي اللي طلعناها اللي هي تقريبا نص مش بتأثر على الفيز شيفت للكوساين؟
أكيد بتأثر على الفيز شيفت، نعم. بس الفيز شيفت بيأثر على الامبليتود؟ سؤال
لا.
ما بيأثرش، انت بدك الامبليتود يتغير الفيز شيفت زي ما بده، ما في مشكله، بس الامبليتود بضل ايش؟ ما لهش علاقه. الكوساين امبليتود لها ثابت 1 regardless of the phase shift. Whatever value you substitute for beta y here, you will get the same magnitude of 1 for the cosine, amplitude of 1. Whatever time you put here, you will get amplitude for the cosine itself is 1. The only term in this expression that affects the magnitudes is exponential minus alpha y. Do you agree?
Doctor.
Yes. Cosine has constant amplitude of 1. Z hat is direction. It has amplitude of 1 also. And theta is constant. So the only thing that makes the wave decay, okay, is exponential, that causes the wave to decay is exponential minus alpha y. This is the only term that causes the wave to decay. As you know, if alpha is equal zero, this means that the wave will not change in amplitude. It will have uniform amplitude. There is no change in amplitude. Now, the last part, if we can continue. Is that okay? اللي كان بيسأل محمد خالد, صح؟
دكتور, تمام.
Is that okay? Okay, fine. Thank you. Okay, we move on now to the last part of the question. Find h at y equal 2 meter and t equal to 1 nanosecond. We have no expression for h, but here, note that since the wave is propagating, you can see it is not standing wave. It is propagating wave. It is one wave, not two waves. Standing wave is two waves, is composed of two waves. But propagating wave is one wave. So you just divide E by the impedance and you change the direction, okay? Because direction of H is perpendicular to E and propagation direction, okay? So now propagation direction is Y and E is Z. So H will be in which direction? It will be in the X direction, okay? It will be in the X direction, as you can see here. Whether it is positive or negative, you have to use the right hand rule. E cross H should point in the propagation direction. Okay, E cross H should point in the propagation direction. Now, H is equal to E as it as is. You put E as it is here. Is E is this equation? We put this equation as is, which is 30 exponential minus alpha y cosine 10 to 9 pi t plus pi over 4 minus beta y. Okay, and this, we put this equation, but we change the direction and we divide by the impedance. The impedance has magnitude and phase. It will affect the magnitude of the wave and the phase of the field. So you divide by the magnitude and you subtract the phase, okay, of eta. When you divide by complex number, you divide by the complex number, which has two components. It has the magnitude and phase. You divide by magnitude and you subtract the phase. Yes. So I divided here by magnitude and subtracted the phase of eta. And the remaining things will remain as is. So eta, as written in the textbook, it is equal by given by this equation, root mu over epsilon, which is for the lossless case, divided by this factor, which accounts for the lossy case, which is 1 plus sigma over omega epsilon squared, all to the power 1 over 4. So just substitution, mu is given, epsilon is given, sigma is given, and you will end up by 188.1 ohm. That's the magnitude of eta. Now, the phase of eta is also given in the textbook. It is 1/2 tan inverse, textbook or other books, or even on the net, you can find the same equation. It is given everywhere. This is a basic equation. So theta, the phase of the impedance is equal 1/2 tan inverse of sine sigma over omega epsilon. Sigma given, omega given, epsilon is given, okay? And you will find that the result is 0.04488 radian, okay? So substitution gives this value. Now here, you put the value of eta magnitude, which is here, 188.1, and you put the value of theta eta in radian here, okay? It will affect pi over 4, of course, and 2 pi, cool. But here we have substituted the value of time here, as you can see, because it is here needed for at time equal 2 nanoseconds and y equal 2 meters. Okay, so here it is alpha y. We substitute here for instead of in place of y by 2. We have replaced y by 2, as it is minus alpha y. So y is 2. 2 comes from the value of y here. And 2 pi, it is pi t, 10 to 9 pi t. And t is 2 nanosecond. Nano will cancel with 10 to 9, okay? And t will be here 2. So it will be here 2 pi. And pi over 4 as it is. And we have beta y. Y is equal to 2, so it will be 2 beta. And theta eta as it is. Now put the value of theta eta and beta and alpha and the magnitude of beta, and you will end up by this value, minus 0.0228. The minus sign comes from the cosine, by the way, from the cosine of the argument here. It is minus 0.0228 x hat ampere per meter. Okay. So now, as you can see, for this direction, E is in the, just to check the direction, E is in the plus y direction, and H is in the x direction here. It is, E is in the z direction. E is in the z direction, and H in the x. So z cross x will give what? E cross H should give a propagation direction. So E like this, I will cancel the sharing, and I will share now the paint. Okay, here I will explain as if we are in the classroom. Explain this. So we have, this is the, we said E is in the Z direction. Yes, this is E. in this direction. Okay, you can see, yes, you can see. You can see the pin. E is in the Z direction, this is E. This is E, you can see E here. I will put E in the bold face and increase the magnitude 16, for example, or even to 20. You can see the symbol E here. Can you see it? E, this electric field in the Z direction. And now the H is in the X direction. Yes. H in which direction? Let me just check to E in the Z direction and H in the X direction. Yes. H in the X direction. Z. And this is X direction H. Okay, this is H in the X direction. Okay. Now, if you cross product or make cross E cross H, in which direction it will be? Z cross X, Z cross X will be in which direction? Anyone can answer? Z
y?
Cross S. And the Y, yes, and positive Y, exactly. So this is the, okay, the propagation direction. This is the wave propagating. This is the Z direction. Yeah. So E cross H, E vector cross H vector will point in the propagation that will give the propagation direction. The direction of E cross H will give propagation direction of the wave. Propagation yeah. Is that clear? So E cross H always gives the propagation direction. We will come to this point. E cross H will get the as value. It will be said it will be the pointing vector, which is related to the power density of the wave. Because it's like voltage times current, you know, volt per meter and current per meter. So it will be watt per meter squared. Okay, we'll go back now to the to our I will stop sharing now and go back to Maxwell. Okay, now you can see. Okay, we have finished that. So I have explained how to find the direction. Now, this is the inside conductor, which is Lissow medium, because we are speaking about Lissow medium. We said that we will use the results of Lissow medium. So this is gamma. This is, we said that gamma is equal to alpha plus J beta. So inside conductor, J in general is equal to J at zero at the initial point, exponential minus is propagating in this direction minus gamma z. This is gamma for conductor. You can find it from the equation that we gave in the class, gamma, or it is here, this equation. Here, this equation is here, alpha and beta. It's alpha plus g beta. For conductor, if you calculate this, you will find that alpha is equal 1 over delta and beta equal 1 over delta, okay? And delta is the skin depth. It is given by this equation, delta, skin depth. You will find this from this equation. You need not to memorize this. This is the equation we said. This is the equation. It will give you alpha and beta for any case. This equation here, you can see, for any case. This equation gives alpha and beta for any case, okay, including conductors. So if you put the values for conductors, you will find that this is the value. For conductor, since sigma is much greater than omega epsilon, you cancel one. This will be much larger than one. So you cancel one. If you cancel one, this will be, and you cancel the one here also. It will be sigma over omega epsilon times mu over epsilon. That's the idea, is that when you are using or you are considering conductor, this means that sigma conductivity is large. It would be much greater than omega epsilon, which means that you cancel one here and you cancel also the one here. So the square root of sigma over omega epsilon squared, all this factor here, it will be equal to sigma over omega epsilon. I do multiply by this. That's all.
Doctor, عندي سؤال.
No, I think we should not cancel. Sorry. Should not cancel, I think, plus or minus one here, because otherwise you will get real. Sorry, make some correction. You cancel the one here only, but you cannot cancel the one here, you know, because this is squared. Plus one, this is not squared, so you cannot cancel this. You do not cancel this. You cancel one here, but you do not cancel this. And you will get the result there. أتفضل, sorry for the interruption.
دكتور بقدر بالبارت الأخير بقدر أستخدم أحد معادلات ماكسويل إيكويشن عشان أوجد الـ H مثلا أستخدم كيرل أوف إي بيساوي
طبعا بس غالبا بدك يعني باخذ وقت طويل وجهد كبير. يعني بده جهد كثير كبير. هنا very simple بقسم مباشرة وخلص معادلة جاهزة بعوض وبقسم. هناك غلب كثير بدك لسه تتغلب تطلع المعادلة بدها صفحة وبعدين تعوض. هنا ما فيش صفحة عندك مباشرة قسمة مباشرة. يعني هناك بدك كومبلكس تعمل الماتريكس تعمل الكيرل كله اوكي وتطلع الريزلت وبعدها توصل لهذا النقطة تصير تعوض. But here direct, just to divide, subtract the phase and put the values. That's it. There it is much difficult. Much sophisticated. Here it is much easier. That's all. But you can, of course, you can use it. You can. But if you are in an exam, I think the time will not save you. Okay. Is that you are satisfied?
Dr. Tamal.
Okay. Now we go here. So this is alpha, which is equal 1 over delta, and this is beta. So if you look here, alpha and beta, okay. Plus and minus 1. Okay, we will see that. We will see that. Okay, now alpha is equal 1 over delta and beta is equal 1 over delta also. So this is only gamma. This is gamma. Okay. So if you want, this is current density. If you want to calculate the total current, you integrate over the cross-sectional area. If the current is in this direction, in the x direction, as you can see, this is y and this is z. And the current is in the x direction. So the area perpendicular to the current is in the y z direction. So integrative with respect to z and y. Now j varies with z only. So y you just multiply by the width, which is w. And you integrate exponential. Exponential easy to integrate because it has constant coefficient. You divide by minus 1 plus g over delta. That's all. And you put the values from 0 to infinity. And you will get this value because this is simple. At infinity, the exponential is equal to 0. And 0, it is equal to 1 over the factor here. And you will get this easy. And this is the total current. This is easy question. This is not requested. Okay, this is the retarded potentials are related to antennas. So just it's not part of this. It is out of the scope of this course. Okay, it is just only one page, I think, or two pages. Antennas, you can see this is the antenna. So we have finished this part now. Any question? So please put a note here that retarded potentials are antennas. Or you can see, if you see it, you will see the antenna. When you see antenna, you will see that this is not part of the this antenna. You can see dipole antenna, this radiation. Radiating, you can see radiating, example, radiating current element. Radiation is antenna, or radiating current element is antenna. So it's not within the scope of this course. Okay. Now we move to the, if there are no questions, we will move to the next part, which is also conductors. We will continue with conductors. You can see. We will continue. Yeah, let's cancel the sharing here and make a new share for the file. Maybe I have to open the file, conductors. Higher conductors. Okay, you can see now the file of it is written on the screen, conductors and skin depths. The same topic that we have already that we are now considering. Conductors and skin depths. صوت مش واضح.
أنا.
اتفضل احمد رائد. تفضل احمد رائد.
عشان
زياد لاني بعدني بالباص. صوتك مش واضح، صوتك بروح بيجي ترى مش واضح.
الفويس از ان كلير. موصل عشان الغياب.
صوتك لو تعيد مرة ثانية.
دكتور بيقول لك هو بالباص عشان الغياب. نروح من الجامعة.
طب شو دخل الباص أو في أي مكان؟ بإمكانه يحضر مو في الباص أو مش في الباص. شو المشكلة؟ مش على التليفون بتحضر يعني سواء باص او مش باص
يو
كان اتند يعني وذر يو ار ان ذا باص اور
هو عشان النت بفصل وبعد شوي انا ناس
انا تقريبا يعني ما افتر ميبي 10 مينتس وي ويل كونسيدر ذا اتندنس سو بليز ريمين وذ اس اوكي Okay, now conductors, it is the same idea. We will continue with the same thing. This chapter is very simple, only one idea, conductors only. Okay. Conductors is, you can see, del cross H Maxwell equation equal J plus dD by dt. Okay. J conduction current is equal sigma times E, and displacement current is epsilon E. So, and d by dt is U omega. And now, if sigma is equal to zero, this will cancel, of course. Okay. If sigma is equal to zero, it is dielectric medium. If sigma is different from zero, then we have lossy medium or imperfect, it is lossy medium. Now, if sigma is much less than omega epsilon, we will say that it is dielectric. Okay. If sigma, if I will read from right to left, you can see. Or if omega epsilon is much greater than sigma, this means that it is dielectric. If sigma is much greater than omega epsilon, this means that conductor, or omega epsilon much less than sigma. If omega epsilon and sigma, neither of them dominates, this means that it is a quasi-conductor. It is not conductor, it is not dielectric, it is in between. So if sigma and the values of sigma and omega epsilon are comparable, then we will say, what's the meaning of this greater and much greater or much less? Here, if sigma or if omega epsilon is 100 times or more as compared with sigma, it is dielectric. If omega epsilon is 100 times greater than sigma, then it is dielectric. If sigma is the same here, sigma, this is the same equation, yes? Less than, okay. If sigma is 100 times greater than omega epsilon, it is conductor. If sigma is much less, is 100 or omega epsilon is 100 times or more greater than sigma, it is dielectric. If sigma is 100 times or more greater than omega epsilon, it is conductor. If sigma is between 1 over 100 and 100 as compared with omega epsilon, it is a quasi-conductor. That's all. So we divide sigma by omega epsilon. If it is less than 0.01, it is dielectric. If it is greater than 100, it is conductor. If it is between 0.01 and 100, it is quasi-conductor. Okay. So the medium, whether the medium is dielectric or conductor, depends on the frequency, because here there is omega. You can see omega. Omega everywhere here. So the medium characteristics depend on the frequency. This is cancelled here. There is an example, simple example here. Assuming we will give this example and stop here. Okay. Assuming epsilon r and sigma are constants with the frequency. In this course, we will always assume that epsilon r and material parameters are constant with the frequency. Okay. Now, epsilon r is constant with the frequency, which is 80, and sigma is equal 4 Siemens per meter. Now, we want you to find sigma over omega epsilon. Sigma is constant, epsilon, so this will be a function of frequency only. This term here, as you can see, sigma over omega epsilon, he assumes that sigma and epsilon are constant with the frequency. So if you substitute the value of sigma of 4 and the value of epsilon r 80 and epsilon naught, of course, you will find an equation or an expression that depends only on the frequency. So sigma is equal to 4, as you can see here. And epsilon is epsilon naught 10 to minus 9 over 36 pi times epsilon r, which is 80. And omega is 2 pi f. So we find the value, this value here. Okay. You find this value, and you will have something divided by frequency. We get here 900 divided by f in megahertz. So I will change the frequency and see what will happen. So I want this, when this is equal 100, this means that this starts to be conductor, because sigma, when this is 100, this means that sigma is 100 omega epsilon. So this is 100 when the frequency is 9 megahertz, as you can see. This is 100 when the frequency is 9 megahertz. And this is 0.01 when the frequency is larger, because when you increase, if the frequency, this term will decrease. So when this is 90,000 megahertz, which is 90 giga, the value is 0.01. So if you see this plot here, if the frequency is 9, the ratio is 100. If the frequency is 90,000, you can see, the ratio is 0.01. Okay. So the higher the frequency, this means that the medium is dielectric. Okay. So for frequencies greater than 90 gigahertz, the medium is dielectric. For frequencies less than 9 megahertz, this means that the medium is the conductor. In between here, the medium is quasi-conductor. That's all the question. I will stop here. Okay.